Hi people, it's me, Anya. Welcome back to my channel. So, in case you didn't notice, I'm going to start uploading 3 times a week. So, Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays. I don't know how I'm going to maintain this once school's in session. I know that by the time you're watching this, I'm already in like my 3rd week of school or whatever. But when I'm filming this, it's the 20th of July. So I'm still on my summer break. I'm still outside, as you can clearly tell. And yeah, I'm social distancing, don't worry.
Yay!
Anyway, so this video is focusing on my favorite, specifically middle grade book series. All of these series are fantasy. I will go into them in more detail, and I will talk about like how many books are in each of these series. So the first series on this list is The Search for Wondra. This is a trilogy. It follows Eva 9, who lives like underground, and she's always wanted to go above ground. So when her wish comes true, she meets both friend and foe. I love this trilogy so much because I just love the inventive world building. I'm pretty sure this trilogy has little like illustrations in the pages, like between the pages. And I love that aspect. I love it when authors include illustrations of like what the characters look like, what the world looks like. It just makes it all the more inventive, you know? I love the plot. I love the cast of characters. Eva 9 is such a wonderful, lovely person. I love her so much. I remember reading this trilogy with such fondness because it's just so good. And I love it, and you should love it too, so please read it.
The next series is called The 13th
Reality Series, written by James Dashnell. By the way, side note, the picture of the series that I show is the first book in the series, just for reference purposes, in case you actually want to look into any of these series.
As you should.
Anyway, The 13th Reality Series follows Tick, who receives a mysterious letter. And he has to follow these 12 riddles. He has to solve these 12 riddles. And at the end of it, he knows that something extraordinary will happen. I feel like that synopsis sounds like super vague, but this series, it has 4 books in it. It's so good. I remember truly loving Tick as a character and the other characters because there are other people who also receive similar mysterious riddles. And like the camaraderie and the friendship between them, it's just so wonderful. James Dashnell does such a great job with his like inventive, innovative world building. The cast of characters was wonderful. The intriguing plot is so great. I know that James Dashnell is a little bit more well known for his Maze Runner trilogy, but this book series should be the series that he is more known for because this series is superior to Maze Runner and it is so good. And I also feel that like that's a little bit unfair for me to say because I only read the first book in the Maze Runner trilogy. But anyway, this series is so good. I love it so much. And I should honestly reread it because it's just so good.
The next book series on this list is a
trilogy, and it is The Kronos Chronicles, written by Marie Lutkowski. I feel like Marie Lutkowski might sound familiar because she recently wrote The Midnight Lie, which I know a lot of people loved, and I didn't. But anyway, The Kronos Chronicles is so good. It follows Petra, whose life is forever changed when the prince steals her father's eyes, and she decides to steal them back, as she should. More power to her. This book was so good. I love this trilogy. Petra is such a wonderful, lovely character. The world building was so imaginative and truly original and like kind of steampunky, if I remember correctly. It's just so good. And this trilogy is just
so good. And I love
Petra as a character. The world building, the eclectic cast of characters is just so wonderful. I look back at this trilogy with such fondness because I remember thoroughly enjoying each of the books
in the trilogy and eagerly
anticipating and looking forward to the next one because I would read them like one at a time and not like all back to back because sometimes they like weren't all available at the library. anyway, this trilogy is just so, so, so good.
The next series on this list is
Alistair Glim's Auditorium, written by Gregory Fornaro. This is a duology. This series is so, so good. It follows Gleb, who doesn't know anything beyond being a chimney sweep. And he's not really appreciated as such. He's only appreciated, like, for what he does, like, as a job. He's not really, like, appreciated as a person until he stows away into this mysterious carriage. And he meets Alistair Glim. And he's swept into this magical, wonderful adventure. I love this duology so, so much. I remember loving this action-packed, fast-paced plot. Not only does this series have an eclectic cast of characters, because I know I've said that for like every single book series before, but this series has a found family. And I love found family. It's one of my favorite tropes. And I just love this series so, so, so much. Grub is such a wonderful person. This was such a wonderful, lovely adventure. The sequel was also just as good. Like, this duology is truly so underappreciated. And I appreciate it so, so much. And you should too, because it's just excellent.
The last series on this list
is the All the Long Questions series, written by Lemony Snicket. Lemony Snicket is a literary genius, and I love him so, 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 so much. I know I say all the time that, like, Leigh Bardugo and Amanda Foody and Tracy Chi are, like, my top three authors or whatever, but Lemony Snicket is truly superior to all of them. I love this series so, so much. Lemony Snicket wrote one of my favorite book series of all time, The Series of Unfortunate Events, and All the Long Questions was so good as well. The Series of Unfortunate Events is still superior, but All the Long Questions is still so, so, so good. It's just so, so wonderful. It follows like a younger Lemony Snicket. So like before the Bond derails, before all of that happened. So like it's set before the Series of Unfortunate Events, but like you don't have to read this series to understand the Series of Unfortunate Events, or vice versa. Like, I read the series after I read Series of Unfortunate Events, because I read this series
like as the books
were coming out, you know? Anyway, this series is so, so good. Lemony Snicket is a wonderful human and just a wonderful author, because he creates such a brilliant world with a brilliant cast of characters. And reading through his, like, younger perspective is just so wonderful. He is so intelligent. I love intelligence. I feed on intelligence. And I love him so much. This series is
so good.
It's just so good. I love Lemony Snicket. If you didn't know already, I just love him. I love this series. Please, please
read it. It's so good. In conclusion, please read all of these book
series because they are so, so good, so incredible. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Comment down below if you've read any of these book series before. If not, your favorite middle grade completed fantasy book series. Yay! I only included completed book series on this list, so I will probably be making a part two if the next book in my uncompleted book series end up being just as good as the previous. I just didn't want to jinx myself and promote other uncompleted book series such as Nevermore and The Book Wonders and Keeper of the Lost Cities in case the next book in this series is like not as amazing as the previous ones, you know? Anyway, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Comment down below your favorites. And yeah, thanks for watching and subscribe if you're new. Bye, see you on Thursday.